पूर्वोत्तरे प्रज्वलिका निदाने सदा वसन्तं गिरिजासमेतं सुरासुराराधितपादपद्मं श्रीवैजनाथं तमहं नमामि। द स्टोरी ऑफ द ओरिजिन ऑफ वैद्यनाथ ज्योतिर्लिंग। द अरगेंट रावण परफॉर्म्ड एन ऑस्टियर पेनेंस एट माउंट कैलासा। Even then, Lord Shiva could not be propitiated by him. Thereupon, he cut off his heads one by one and offered them to the phallic image of Lord Shiva. Thus, when he had cut off his 9 heads and 1 head remained, Lord Shiva appeared in front of him. The Lord reinstated the 9 severed heads in a trice and conferred upon him matchless strength as desired by Ravana. Having sought the boon, Ravana asked Lord Shiva to accompany him to Lanka. He agreed to his request unwillingly. He advised Ravana, "Let my excellent phallic image be taken to Lanka for worship. But wherever it is placed on the ground, it shall become stationary there." And then, as soon as Lord Shiva vanished from the scene, Ravana set out to Lanka with the Lord's image. On the way, propelled by the call of nature, he handed over the image to a cowherd. The cowherd felt distressed by its heavy weight. The moment he placed it on the ground, it remained fixed there. Thereupon, Ravana was inspired to worship Lord Shiva there, and then Indra and other gods also reached there. After having a direct vision of Lord Shiva at the holy spot, the gods with all the religious rites established the phallic image of the Lord there and named it Vaidyanatha. When Ravana returned to Lanka, the gods were very apprehensive of his unequal strength, as he might torment them by virtue of the boon which he had acquired from Lord Shiva. So they sent Narada to Ravana in order to misguide him. Having reached Lanka, sage Narada said to Ravana, "You should lift up Mount Kailasa in order to test the efficacy of the boon given to you." Ravana realized that sage Narada was right. Reaching there, he uprooted Mount Kailasa and lifted it up. At the behest of Parvati, Lord Shiva, considering Ravana to be ungrateful, cursed him saying, "O wicked-minded demon, don't be arrogant of your might. You and your entire dynasty shall be exterminated. Lord Vishnu shall incarnate himself to bring about your destruction." Hearing these words of Lord Shiva, Ravana came back to Lanka from Mount Kailasa. Lord Rama, the incarnation of Vishnu, was born of King Dashratha of Ayodhya as his son in the Treta era to fulfill the curse uttered on Ravana by Lord Shiva. But Ravana was not to be killed without the support of Lord Shiva. That is why Lord Shiva himself descended upon this earth in the incarnation of Hanuman, so that the creation might be protected against the atrocities inflicted by Ravana and other demons. Thereafter, Rama, with the help of the Rudra form of Hanuman, succeeded in slaying Ravana. Om Namah Shivaya.